This week's Ask Dr. Duri comes from a lady who is concerned to know, should she have MRD testing performed in her case? And so she's talking about testing for minimal residual disease, which is something that has been widely discussed, particularly in the last 2, 3, 4 years. And so her specific question is, in my case, should I ask my doctor to do testing of my bone marrow to see if there is a small amount of myeloma left in the bone marrow at the level of, let's say, 1 in a million cells, which is the level of sensitivity for many of the testings. And so should she have this testing to see if, when this is done, out of a million cells, maybe she has no myeloma left, what would we do with this information? So really, really good and important question here in 2018. The answer is that within clinical trials, we understand now that this information is extremely important. If one particular treatment produces an MRD negative result in, let's say, 70% of the patients, and another treatment produces an MRD negative result in 30% of the patients, then obviously that deeper response is a better response, and one treatment could be considered to be significantly better than another. But what about just running the test for an individual patient? So let's say this lady had her test run. She's taking lenalidomide, Revlimid, as a maintenance, and the test comes back negative. She's got no cells at this 1 in a million level. So the problem is, well, what are we going to do? Because if the test is negative, that means that the Revlimid maintenance has been working. And so should she continue it? Or is it safe at this point to stop after maybe 1 or 2 years? Well, the problem is we don't know the answer to that right now. The opposite possibility would be that we run the test and the test is positive. And so the same problem arises. So if the test is positive, what are we going to do? Is it okay maybe to try to continue with the treatment for another 6 months or a year, and then maybe the test would become negative? Or if it's positive, should we immediately be thinking to stop or change the treatment? And so you can see right there that the problem is that without more clinical trial information, we don't exactly know what the recommendations should be at this time point. And so the bottom line right now is that the MRD testing is just not ready for prime time. It can be helpful and reassuring and interesting in individual cases, but truthfully, we do not 100% know what to recommend for an individual patient. My personal inclination is that if the test is negative, counterintuitively, maybe the smart thing is to continue with a maintenance that does seem to be working. And on the opposite side, if I get a positive result, I'd be more inclined to stop or change the treatment. And so routine testing is not recommended. We are absolutely looking at this carefully within clinical trials. And over the next 2, 3, 4 years, we will have better and more decisive recommendations that we will be able to make to guide patient decisions.